For Expert Village, this is Kurt, N7QJM. Today we're talking about... You're listening to actual Morse code at 10 words per minute in preparations for the test. I used a cassette tape off of this particular series to actually study through some things. Can you recognize any of the code? Can you recognize any of it? I hope you can hear a little of it there. That'll tell you a little about preparation and study for the tests. You can use these preparation guides. I'll try and get it in here so you can see it. But these preparation guides are excellent. You can also use the internet. Now there's one other thing, and I want to show you a quick graphic here of my log. The logs are also very important to keep so that you can keep track of who you're communicating with and when and what conditions were like. You can go back. Now before, in the years ago, you would have to have a log file. But of course now, as you can see here, you don't need to keep them anymore. I tend to do it simply out of convenience sake, and it's always nice to keep track of who I've talked to and some of the important events that have happened. Now there's one other piece here that you can do, and that is who you talk to. I like to log those in. Sometimes I can't get the complete call or I don't have the right address or something or another, and I use what I call this particular piece here. You can get them on DVD or on CD. Let's see if this is in focus in any way, shape, or form. These are just optical media, and it contains the amateur ham radio call book, the entire call book, which used to be in paper form. It contains it all. These are typically made by Buckmaster. I pay for this. You can get a subscription service and have the log of all of the hams worldwide that have been registered anyway into a database that runs off of these disks. So there you have it with the logbook and a little bit of Morse code at 10 words a minute. We'll close out with some more Morse code. As we leave, we're going to be saying 73s. Okay, well, that does it in terms of this particular series. Be sure to check my other series on amateur radio or ham radio. You can search for it either way here on Expert Village. Again, I'm Kurt Glaser, N7QJM. Thanks for watching. Be sure to put comments down, and if I can be of any help, go ahead and send an email. My email address is online there as well, and we'll try to assist you, or at least steer you in the right direction for amateur radio operating. Again, it's N7QJM. We are off in 73s.